So let's say you've been happily developing with Unity, when your pointy-haired boss comes into the room and says,
I need you to build a 3D terrain demo for a website.
No problem, you think to yourself. Unity has some pretty decent terrain tools. You should be able to whip that up in no time. But then the boss adds,
without using any plugins.
This is not exactly what you wanted to hear, so you try to explain that the Unity plugin already has a huge install base and should not be a problem. But the boss insists and suggests that you use WebGL instead. It's her decision, and WebGL sounds pretty cool, so you get to work. You look around for a while, and you realize that there really isn't much out there to make this process easy. If only you could use Unity, the engine that you know and love. But then you start to think about what Unity really is. As a game engine, it's composed of both a runtime player and an offline editor. Well, the runtime is what requires the plugin, but the editor, what can we do with just that? So let's see. It allows you to paint terrain using a technique called texture splatting. And that's just a fancy way of mixing textures together. For example, if you have just grass and dirt, you'll want some areas that are just grass, some that are just dirt, and some that are a combination of both. Of course, you can use more than just those two textures, but splatting is the technique that makes this all easily possible. This is all really cool stuff. But once you're done and you have your terrain looking just how you want it, how do you get that data out of the editor so you can use it with WebGL? There doesn't appear to be a way to do that. So you look into the script documentation, and you see some things that just might work. You follow that lead, and a few hours later you emerge victorious with a script that allows you to export your splat texture. It's smooth sailing from here. You plug that data into the amazing WebGL library 3.js, and you recreate the terrain just as you saw it in the editor. The task is complete, and your boss is happy. Lesson learned, just because you can't use Unity's runtime player doesn't mean you can't use the editor. In this case, it allowed you to quickly create and visualize your terrain in a very short amount of time.